still look, huh?
No, but do you know what the real question is? Did you see One Life to Live where this dude and then this other dude and like his dad? You don't remember that? Who?
Who?
Oh, let me guess. It's a yellow-bellied sapsucker.
A what?
You know that bird I saw on PBS last night while I was waiting for all those job offers to come through?
Susan, have you had a chance to think about what we discussed last week?
Thinking.
Is that all you do is think? You'll get a brain tumor if you keep thinking so much.
Is that right?
Yeah, didn't your daddy ever tell you that?
Let's talk about your dad.
Let's not.
When was the last time you saw him?
Last night, in a nightmare.
Wasn't it last Christmas when you were home from school?
Yes, you found me out. I did it. I'm so ashamed.
Susan, you were quite a piece of work.
Thanks.
Now, come on, we've got a lot of work to do.
Well, fine, if you don't think that way about it.
Let's talk about your dad.
Well, it was my first visit home to college. And I was excited to go home. I walked into the front door, and of course, my mom was there to greet me with a big hug.
Where was your dad?
Eating dinner. It was 5:37.
Is that important?
Yes, the dinner is at 5:30 sharp.
Why was that?
Because that's when the cavemen ate.
And when it was good enough for them, it was good enough for us.
I see.
Yeah, see, it was Friday night, meatloaf night, and of course, Friday night has always been synonymous with meatloaf. God forbid we eat anything but meatloaf on Friday night.
Okay, it was Friday night.
Meatloaf night.
Right.
And I became a vegetarian while I was in college.
And
my dad thought that was the most asinine thing ever.
If God didn't want us to eat meat, he would have made animals.
What did you say to that?
I said, Dad, if you just think about it for a moment.
What's there to think about? God made cows, we eat meatloaf. God made pigs, we eat pork chops. God made chicken, we eat chicken.
Did you eat the meatloaf?
I should have. It would have made the night salvageable.
What do you mean?
Well, it was, they asked me questions about college. You know, did I like my professors? Did I like the classes I was taking? Did I like any boys? Did I find a church I belong to?
What?
I should have stopped while I was ahead.
What do you mean?
Well, see, my parents are very religious. You know, growing up, we went to church every Sunday morning, every Sunday evening, every Wednesday evening, and every time the church happened to be unlocked.
Did you enjoy going?
I don't know. Going to church was like up there with personal hygiene. We just did it.
So what happened with your dad?
Well, you're so nosy. He was like,
what do you mean you didn't go to church?
Because I don't want to go to church.
What do you mean you don't want to go to church?
Because I don't think I believe in God.
What?
Well, Dad, if you just listen and think about it for a minute.
What do you mean think about it for a minute? We put you going to church, that's reason enough.
Dad, it's not reason enough. I just don't want to go. And then he got mad. So we sent you to church, $10,000 for education, and then you don't want to go? So you can act and think an atheist? I said, Dad, I don't know, that's not it.
What did he say?
He just left. I went after him, but there's just three things I don't talk to my dad about. Religious, politics, and meatloaf. I wanted to yell after him, but then I voted for Obama, so that would just be pressing my luck.
Susan, how do you feel?
Oh, lonely, sad, hurt, brokenhearted. Genuinely pretty crummy. My dad, he's so pathetic. He spends his life committed to something he doesn't know nothing about. Because I do want to believe in God and Jesus and all that, but right now, I just can't.